Hi and welcome to Dr. Mix. On this episode, I'm going to explain to you what DJs actually do. That's coming up. Hey guys, great to have you here today. Do you know what? DJing is a little bit of a controversial subject, especially for classically trained musicians like myself. I spent a lot of time on my instrument, on my orchestration degree, and I was a little bit of a snob towards DJs, I confess. But guess what? I was wrong. So, you know, a lot of people don't understand what they do. All they see is like somebody getting agitated and you know, pushing buttons apparently without any any reason. But look, I'm going to debug what DJs actually do, and I'm gonna do it right now. So what is this? This is a modern configuration of the traditional idea of having one deck to the left, one deck to the right, and the mixer in the center. In this specific case, this is just a controller that makes everything happen here within the computer. So I've got my left deck going, my right deck going. But the configuration in terms of where everything is located is exactly like an old school vinyl set where you have your first vinyl to the left, second vinyl to the right, and the mix in the center. It's the same thing for the CDJ setup. It's just the idea that you can basically play continuously from the left deck to the right deck and vice versa with the music never ending. But how does that actually happen? So say that you are playing a track right here, okay? So you've got it right there. Then you want to mix into the other one. Of course, it's gonna have to go to the same rhythm. With these modern machines, you can simply sync, and the next track will be automatically synchronized without having to work too hard. You can do it manually if you like to do it manually. You could do it automatically if you like to do it automatically. I don't measure how good a DJ is by the fact that he uses synchronization or not. You know, deliver me great music, entertain me, make me dance. That's what I care about it. So say that I have this track going here, right? All right. Now I want to go gradually to the track that is on the right. So what I can do is that, for example, I can turn the high, the mids, and the lows all the way down, and then I start bringing it in. At some point, I swap and I pull the highs and remove the highs from the previous track. Now all of a sudden I've got sealed the same groove on the low and the mids, but I've got a different bit on the highs. So then the next bit can be I replace the kick drum and the bass. Alright? So I'm doing that gradually. And eventually I can even cut the mids. And now I have transitioned to the next track. That's pretty easy, right? But of course there can be limitations. You know, one track may be in one key, the next track could be in a different key. They have different tonal centers, so it's hard to mix them together. So when you see that the DJ is, you know, doing a lot of movements and pushing buttons, most likely what they're doing is they're looping the song. Let me show you what I mean by that. So say that I've got this song going, right? So we are to the end of the song, right? Now I can hit a special button that starts looping. All right? See how this goes back, right? I'd rather not use some place where I have that crash because, you know, that may come a little bit too often, but I will start here, for example. Now I've got an 8-beat loop. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. All right? Now, I've got this under control. I know what's happening. I know I'm not gonna have surprises, elements coming in that are not expected. This is on a loop and it's gonna keep on looping. Now, on the other hand, I've got this guy, right? All right, let's start it from the beginning, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna loop this guy too. 8-beat, okay? So I know that here I've got this, and here I've got this. So I can simply start mixing it in. Maybe take the lows out. All right? It's seamless. You cannot hear that I'm doing it, but I am doing it. And then at some point I decide to swap the lows. All right? Now I've got the whole of a new song coming in, and this one is on the way out. So I can slightly turn it down, and then finally I can liberate the loop, and this track keeps on rolling. All right? The last thing that I want to explain is that you can use some effects in order to make this transition even smoother. Let me show you that. So let's go to another bit of this song, for example. Well, let's remove the loop. Right? Let's go there. Okay. Loop. All right, so I want to mix it to the next song. All right, let's loop that as well. So now I can decide to put some effect on this one, like some delay. And then I can decide to start filtering it. I'm removing the low end, progressively all the way to the top. And then I introduce the new track. I liberate the loop and I let the track keep on going. I put all the feedback all the way long. And I have transitioned to the new track. So I hope you understand that, you know, DJing well is not easy. DJing badly, that's quite easy. So the next time you decide to bash a DJ, bash him because he's a bad DJ, not because he's just a DJ. You know, I am so lucky I get to travel the world to see the world's top DJs, and believe me, they are incredible musicians. In any case, if this inspires you, I hope you consider subscribing to this channel, and I will see you next time. Thank you for watching.